awesome. We want to welcome you to Double N this morning for worship, and what a day to be thankful. We got great sunshine, great cool weather, rain's coming. It's going to be awesome. Let's go to the Lord. Lord, we thank you for this day. We thank you for the blessings you've given us. Thank you for the wonderful Thanksgiving, Lord, that we so rightly don't deserve. Lord, thank you for loving us. Thank you for forgiving us, being with us during this service, Lord, to open our hearts and minds. These things we ask in your precious name of Jesus. Amen.
Come all ye faithful, joyful and play for you, ba-rum-ba-bum-bum, on my drum.
Put it ba-rum-ba-bum-bum. The ox and lamb kept time, ba-rum-ba-bum-bum. I played my drum for him, ba-rum-ba-bum-bum. I played my best for him, ba-rum-ba-bum-bum, rum-ba-bum-bum, rum-ba-bum-bum. Then he smiled at me, ba-rum-ba-bum-bum, me and my drum.
Hey, good morning. You know, I'm telling you, Big E back here, he lives for this time of year, all right? So that they can play that song right there and he can showcase some talents on them drums. Oh, man, everybody doing okay? We got any Aggies in here? Is there any Aggies in here? Isn't today a great day? It's a great day, isn't it? It's a great day. Man, you just got, who was our Aggie? I'm sorry. Oh, bless your heart. I'm sorry. I know, but man, oh, man, oh, man. Hey, let me do some real quick announcements and everything. But hey, Gene, there's a video in there. All right, I think it's back there with Jeff Scripture and Van. If you can turn that up just a little bit. I've got to do this because if you know Wyatt Watson, Wyatt is an Aggie. I mean, this dude bleeds maroon. And anyways, we made a little friendly little wager, and Wyatt held up his end of the deal last night. So you're gonna have to turn it up so we can hear it. You got it up there? All right, go ahead and hit play, because Wyatt, I know you're watching, bud. Wyatt, buddy, I know you're watching this morning. Appreciate you, and goodness gracious, man, goodness gracious. Anyways, that's my last Aggie joke, I promise you. A lot of stuff going on this next week, a lot of things taking place. If you've got your bulletin, you've seen it all in there. Any first-time guests in here with us today, man, thank you for being with us. Thank you for coming and checking us out. I hope you leave here blessed today. There's going to be a Christmas parade this coming Saturday. If you got kids, adults, it don't matter, any of you, if you want to ride on the float, you're more than welcome to ride on the float. I think they're going to have the teenagers decorate it Wednesday evening. But 5 o'clock up at old Memorial Stadium, and that thing's going to get started at 6. Angel Tree, if you'd like to adopt one of the angels, I think that's available today. Am I right there? You can see Melissa right over here, and she can get you worked out. Quilting Work Day this Saturday. Children's Christmas program is at that's next Sunday. Want the kids here by 9:30. Oh, so in other words, have them here by 9:15. All right, have your kids here by 9:15 if they are a part of that, if they're going to be participating in that. Christmas Eve, we're going to have our candlelight service. We'll observe the Lord's Supper and all of that on Christmas Eve. It's always a beautiful, beautiful service, so make plans to be here at 6 o'clock on December 24th. Now, before I dismiss you to do all that, Tyler, huh? Tyler, did you have a birthday yesterday? How old are you now? 12 years? Did you get 12 licks yesterday? Yeah. No, you didn't? You got out of it? Well, you're going to get it today, okay? All right. Happy birthday, Tyler. Before we get out of here today, I'm going to do all this really, really quick because we got a lot of things that got to take place today after the service. At the end of the service, we need some strong young men and young ladies who will go up in the attic and get all that beautiful Christmas stuff, all that stuff down here, so that all the ladies going to be working on that this week can get that decorated. We also need some help. We're going to swap out the wagon. We're going to pull this wagon out, put it in the trailer, and we're going to bring another wagon in. Maybe it's going to look a little bit different and everything. So I need somebody. I don't care who it is. Don't come ask me who. I need somebody to go back and get that after service, get that big white trailer, pull it around here, back it up to that door so we can load that thing in there, then we're going to swap them out. So need to break that thing down. So if you've done that before, please help us out with that. It's going to be absolutely, this place is going to look completely different when you come next week. Now that's all I got to say. All right, I think. Is there anything else I need to say?
Breathe.
Okay, all right, everybody stand up. Man, if you guys, and let me tell you this. Please go find somebody you don't know. Shake their hand. Give them a hug. If you're in a small group, invite them to your small group. Get plugged in somewhere. But we're going to give you 60 seconds to go around and say hello really, really quick. We'll dismiss the kids. The kids are out. Let these guys lead us, continue leading us in worship. Y'all pray with me. Father, as we come to you this morning, Lord, we thank you for today. Father, we thank you for, for this time of year. Father, we thank you for the changing of the seasons. Lord, we thank you for, God, just the opportunity that we have had this last week, Lord, to celebrate thankfulness. Father, I pray that each and every one of us, Lord, that we truly took the time, Lord, to reflect. Lord, on the blessings that each and every one of us have. Lord, no matter what our circumstances are right now, God, we've all got something that we're to be thankful for. And Father, we thank you for that. Father, as we begin preparing, Lord, for a celebration, Father, for the celebration of the birth of Jesus. Father, I pray that as we make this journey towards Christmas Day, God, that each and every one of us, Lord, that we will be reminded, Father, of what this season is truly about. Father, help us to not get distracted and not get caught up in all the busyness and all that other stuff that the world wants to throw at us. But Father, that we would remember what it is truly, truly about. Lord, I pray that our worship is pleasing to you this morning. Father, as Jeff brings the word, God, I pray you just fill him with your Holy Spirit. And Lord, that you would speak through him, I know you have given him an amazing message for each and every one of us. Father, may our hearts be attentive. Lord, may we be here for you. Lord, may we not only be here for you, but Lord, when we walk out of this place, Lord, may we walk out changed. Jesus, we love you, we praise you, and we ask all this in your most precious and holy name. Amen.
I've done all I can. I'm gonna hand the fight to you. I ain't afraid of facing spears and swords. I know the battle is the Lord's. My praise gonna shake these rafters. These walls gonna fall like Jericho. stand back, watch the enemy scatter. Hands high like the fight don't matter. His victory I already know. Stand back, watch the enemy scatter. Your word is my shield, my strength and my help. Its power can close the gates of hell. For I hit the front line, you've already gone before. I know that I know the battle is the Lord's. My praise gonna shake these raptors, these walls gonna fall like Jericho. Stand back, watch the enemy scatter. Hands high like the fight don't matter. Watch the enemy scatter. Singing glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. My God is marching on. Singing glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. My God is marching on. The enemy scatter. Hands high like the fight don't matter. His victory I already know. Stand back, watch the enemy scatter. My praise gonna shake these rafters. These walls gonna fall like Jericho. Stand back, watch the enemy scatter. Hands high like the fight don't matter. His victory I already know. Stand back, watch the enemy scatter.
Hiding from the storm, found no place at the keeper's door. It was for this a child was born, save a world so cold and hollow. The sleeping town they did not know, the lying in a manger low. Savior King who had no hope has come to heal our sorrows. Is there room in your heart? Is there room in your heart? Is there room in your heart for God to write his story? Shepherds counting sheep at night, do not fear the glory light. You are precious in his sight. God has come to raise the lowly. Is there room in your heart? Is there room in your heart? Is there room in your heart for God to write his story? You can come as you are, but it may set you apart when you make room in your heart and trade your dreams for his glory. Make room in your heart. Your heart. Mother holds the promise tight. Every wrong will be made right. The road is straight, the burden's light. For in his hands he holds tomorrow. Is there room in your heart? Is there room in your heart? Is there room in your heart for God to write his story? You can come as you are, but it may set you apart when you make room in your heart and trade your dreams for his glory. Your heart, make room in your
about my Jesus. He makes a way where there ain't no way. Rises up from an empty grave. Ain't no sinner that he can't save. Let me tell you about my Jesus. His love is strong and his grace is free. And the good news is I know that he can do for you what he's done for me. Let me tell you about my Jesus. Now let my Jesus change your life. Hallelujah. 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 Amen. Amen. He can wipe away the tears from broken dreams and wasted years. Tell the past to disappear, oh. Let me tell you about my Jesus and all the wrong turns that you would go and undo if you could. Who can work it all for your good? Let me tell you about my Jesus. He makes a way where there ain't no way. Rises up from an empty grave. Strong and his grace is free, and the good news is I know that he can do for you what he's done for me. Let me tell you about my Jesus. Let my Jesus change your life. Hallelujah. 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 Amen. Amen. Take my cross to Calvary, pay the price for all my guilty. Who would care that much about me? Let me tell you about my Jesus. Oh, he makes a way where there ain't no way. Rises up from an empty grave. Ain't no sinner that he can't save. Let me tell you about my Jesus. His love is strong and his grace is free. And the good news is I know that he can do for you what he's done for me. Let me tell you about my Jesus. Let my Jesus change your life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Will you all pray with me? Dear Lord, I just want to thank you for this day and thank you for the holiday you just gave us, Lord, to give us an opportunity to gather with our families. You know we need more of those in this world, Lord. I just pray that you're with Jeff as he brings you our message today, Lord, and that his message is everything that you want us to hear, Lord. It's in your name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Man, I tell you what, we are so blessed in this church with this worship team. Amen. Yeah. You know, it's kind of ironic. My message today is on names, and I can't remember any of these guys' names, but that drummer wears me out. I'm exhausted by the time I get up here. How about y'all? But, it is so good to be worshiping with our family today, and we've been on the road here a while, but it is great to be here, and as Jimmy said earlier, of course, first of all, you know, I learned a long time ago when I was in Alabama, never talk college football in Alabama, and that's the case in Texas, because, dude, we're trying to unite our country and our church, and you created division in here this morning. So it doesn't matter if you wear orange or that other color. it doesn't matter. We're all one family, right? But so I got to tell you, this message has kind of been on my heart for about 3 or 4 weeks, and it really started, I was reading God's Word, I was going through the book of Matthew, but our directors' meetings, we have these conference calls, try to have them every week with the directors from AFCC, and it is nothing but a bunch of name-calling, all right? They have different, and really, our pastor out here is one of the biggest instigators in the deal. I'm not going to say he is the instigator. Homer Dickey is the instigator. That's on film, Jimmy. They've got it recorded so you can send it to him. But they call each other names. And most of the time it's nice, right? Most of the time. But as I was thinking about this and thinking about our church here and American Fellowship, and names are important. Then I was reading in Matthew, and Jesus is asking, we're going to read this in a minute. I actually heard the song by Casting Crowns. Some of you have heard that song, Who Am I? It's a good song. But, you know, Jesus asked that question. But this morning I want us to just take a moment and think about how important are names. We have so much in our world to be thankful for. We just celebrated Thanksgiving, and truthfully, as Christ followers, we are to be celebrating Thanksgiving every day of the year. We are to be celebrating the birth of Christ every day. But man, we have so much to be thankful. But here's the truth, guys, we get things messed up. We're thankful for the stuff we have, we're thankful for the opportunities, we're thankful for titles, all of this stuff, and I want it going on record, I absolutely hate titles. I don't like titles. I don't like being given a name badge, and you know, they make fun of me because my title is executive director. I won't go into that. You think about the initials and you'll figure it out why I hate it so much. But I remember years ago at Riding the River when we got started. Of course, it was a different crowd down there. And they would come up and say, what are we supposed to call you? Because some of them come out of the Catholic Church and all these other churches. And of course, I've told you the story about one of my elders, Wayne Mangum, called me Father Jeff, which he really knew made me mad. But they would ask, what are we supposed to call you? And I remember looking them in the eye and say, call me Jeff. Not Jeffrey, Jeff. Jeffrey is reserved for my wife and my mom. That's usually when I'm in trouble. If I hear that, holy crappeth, I prefer Jeff. But as we go through this today, I want to ask you this question. Who are you? Who am I? Who are you? As we look at God's Word this morning, we're going to be in Matthew chapter 16. We're going to be jumping around, but mainly it's in Matthew 16, verses 13 through 18. I know we've got that one up here, so follow along with me as we read God's Word this morning. Matthew 16, 13. When Jesus came to the region of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, who do people say that the Son of Man is? Well, they replied, some say John the Baptist, some say Elijah, and others say Jeremiah or one of the other prophets. But then he asked them, who do you say I am? Simon Peter answered, you are the Messiah,
the Son of the living God. Jesus replied, You are blessed, Simon, son of John, because my Father in heaven has revealed this to you. You did not learn this from any human being. Now I say to you that you are Peter, which means rock, and upon this rock I will build my church, and all the powers of hell will not conquer it. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for your word this morning. And Lord, I just pray that you hide me behind your word, you hide me behind your cross. God, that when we leave here today, Lord, we'll leave better than when we got here, but not as good as we're going to be tomorrow. But Lord, we'll leave here today knowing exactly who we are in relation to you. Father, I pray that you just bring revelation to all of us today, Lord, that we're able to see your word with your eyes, to hear it with your ears. And then, Lord, not just see it and hear it, but, Lord, be able to profess it to people in our family, people in our communities. Lord, be able to profess it to those that need you so desperately. Lord Jesus, I thank you for saving a messed up sinner like me, and it's in your blessed name we pray. Amen. I want you to think about this passage just a minute, because Jesus is talking to his disciples. And again, he asked them, Who am I? Who do you say that I am? And Simon Peter says these words, again, looking at this, he says, You are the Messiah, the Son of the living God. You see, names are important. Do you believe that? How many of you absolutely like your name? Yes, no? Some of you are bold enough to say, Yeah, I like my name. I got to be honest with you. I like my first name, but I don't know what my mom and dad were thinking with my middle name. I know who I'm named after. It's my great uncle. It's Uncle Carol. But let me tell you, as a teenager, when the teacher's calling your name and she says, Jeffrey Carroll, where are you? It's like I'm looking around like, who in the world would name their kid Carroll? A guy, right? That was my uncle's name. It's my dad's middle name. If I hear Jeffrey Carroll to this day, I cringe a little bit, because mom could belt that off, all the syllables, and it was bad. But I want to tell you that our names are important and they mean something. In here, we just read this story, and Simon Peter says, You are the Messiah, the Son of the living God. That word in the ESV is translated, Simon said, You are the Christ. You see, I want you to hear something first, that Jesus' name is important. I know we're fixing to celebrate the Christmas season, and I want to start out and go back to Matthew chapter 1, verses 18 through 23. When we talk about the birth of Jesus, listen to this story in Matthew chapter 1, verses 18 through 23. This is how Jesus, the Messiah, was born. His mother, Mary, was engaged to be married to Joseph. But before the marriage took place, while she was still a virgin, she became pregnant through the power of the Holy Spirit. Joseph, to whom she was engaged, was a righteous man and did not want to disgrace her publicly, so he decided to break the engagement quietly. As he considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream. Joseph, son of David, the angel said, Do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child within her was conceived by the Holy Spirit, and she will have a son. Listen, important to this part, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. And all of this occurred to fulfill the Lord's message through the prophet. Look, the virgin will conceive a child. She will give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, which means God is with us. Guys, I want you to understand, Jesus didn't have a title. He didn't have a name badge that said this is who he is. His very name identified who he was and why God sent him here. His very name identifies why we believe and worship him. If we look at this, and I don't want to get real technical because I'm not a real technical person, and I'm sure somebody can argue some stuff, but I looked up the word Emmanuel, the name Emmanuel. The Greek meaning of this name is God is with us. We just saw that in Scripture. The name Messiah, Jesus' name, the one that Simon used in the Greek, it means the anointed one, the chosen one. The name that we refer to Jesus, it is actually comes from a word, and I'll butcher this, I'm sure, Yehoshua. That name simply means, importantly means, the Lord is our Savior. If you think about that, his name identifies who he is and what God has sent him to do, and that's to be our Savior. I don't think we can argue about the name of Jesus, how precious it is, because you get to Philippians 2, and if you believe anything in this Bible, believe this for sure. I believe every bit of it, Genesis to Revelation, but hear these words, Philippians chapter 2, verses 9 through 11. Therefore, God elevated him, Jesus, to the place of highest honor and gave him the name above all names, that at that name of Jesus, every knee should bow in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue declare that Jesus Christ is the Lord, to the glory of God the Father. You're wondering, why am I going on and on about the name of Jesus? Because if I'm going to identify as a Christ follower, do you know the name Christian means Christ follower, Christ-like? If we're going to identify as Christians, if we're going to identify as a church body of those who believe in Jesus Christ, then we have to understand that his name is important. But then that brings us to the point today. What about your name? Is your name important? You see, it's not about titles. It's not about those things that we put up there. It's about your name. Your name is important, especially to Jesus. I love how the scripture, and last week as we were listening to Jimmy driving down the road and he was preaching out of 1 Kings, it was actually 1 Kings 19:9. It's where God is speaking, and he speaks to Elijah and he says, "Where are you, Elijah?" If we look through God's word time after time, the Lord speaks to people, and what does he do? He calls them by name. Just this story we just read in Matthew here in 16, where he says, "You are Simon Peter." You are Peter, meaning the rock, and on your name I will build this church, because his name is important. Guys, your name is important. I love the story that they probably taught down that hall to our kids, the story of Zacchaeus. So what happens? Jesus is walking down and he looks up in that sycamore tree. Wish I could sing, because I'd love to sing that song, but I'm not going to sing. But he looks up in that sycamore tree and he says, "Zacchaeus, come down." What did he do? He called him by name. How many of you ever heard Pastor Jimmy or anybody else preach from the book, some of the books that Paul wrote? I know you have. You can shake your head. Yes, he preaches out of the New Testament a lot too. We all do, because it motivates us, it inspires us. But if we look at that story of how Paul came about, he's on the road to Damascus and the voice from heaven shouts down, the Lord is speaking, and he says, "Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me?" He didn't just look down and say, "Hey, you Christian killer there." No, he calls him by name. And God calls each and every one of us by name. He has called and he is calling each and every one of us by name. God called out Saul and asked, "Why is he persecuting me?" But then he also called out to a man named Ananias and said, "You need to be prepared, because Saul's coming to your house." Maybe today, for some of you in this building, God is calling you by name. Are you listening? Are you listening to me? You see, names are important, and God is calling and has called all of us. Isaiah 43:1. Love this scripture. It says, "But now, O Jacob, listen to the Lord who created you. O Israel, the one who formed you says, do not be afraid, for I have ransomed you. I have called you by name, and you are mine." So why is your name important? Why is your name important? You see, our name reflects who we are. I love giving Jimmy a hard time. I know that a lot of you, out of respect, you call him Pastor Jimmy. I love it that our good friends Joel and Carla are here, because Joel's called me Preacher Man forever. I love that. But at the end of the day, he's Jimmy Holloman. He's not Tracy's husband. He's not just Brady's dad. He's not just Carol's little brother, right? Younger brother. I personally still like the name Reverend James. I think it fits him. That's a good time for an amen. Amen. Reverend James, that's what we're going to put up there. But at the end of the day, please hear this. At the end of the day, when we stand before God Almighty, when we stand and give account of our life, and we're going to read in Revelations here in a minute a story, but when we stand before God, our title's not going to mean squat to God. There's not going to be a certain line that says, okay, the Republicans, because they have conservative values, are here and those other people are over there. No, it's your name. It's not going to be because you were the director or a pastor or any of these other titles that's going to set you apart. Jesus knows your name. He knows your name. And that's what's important. But you see, our name goes even beyond just who we are. It reflects our identity. I love what Jared Hill is one of our camp directors for the Oklahoma camp. Jared said this several years ago at a camp meeting. We usually look at the wrong source to see someone's identity. We usually look at the wrong source to see someone's identity. How many people do you know that have a title and you automatically identify them as their title, but you really never get to know them? You know, when I made that comment earlier, when people ask, what do you want to be called? I want to be called Jeff, because I want people to get to know who Jeff is. Now, I'm going to tell you, Jeff is broken and messed up, and it is by grace I am saved. It is through the power of the Holy Spirit, through the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ, that I am forgiven, because I mess up daily. But at the same time, I want people to know that I am a believer and an heir to the kingdom of God. Now, does my name reflect the identity of Christ? Does your name reflect the identity of Christ? Do you hear what I'm saying this morning? Every one of us in here have a name. Is there anybody in here that does not have a name? I want to meet you, because we want to name you today. And I've got some good ones. We all have a name, right? But does our name reflect the identity of Jesus Christ living in us? Listen to these words out of Matthew 7, 15 through 20. I'm not sure Gene was going to try and get that up there, because I just added that this morning. Matthew chapter 7, starting in verse 15. Says, beware of false prophets who come disguised as harmless sheep, but are really vicious wolves. You can identify them by their fruit, that is, by the way they act. Can you pick grapes from thorn bushes, or figs from thistles? A good tree produces good fruit, and a bad tree produces bad fruit. A good tree can't produce bad fruit, and a bad tree can't produce good fruit. So every tree that does not produce good fruit is chopped down and thrown into the fire. Yes, just as you can identify a tree by its fruit. Listen up if you tune me out. Just as you can identify a tree by its fruit, so you can identify people by their actions. I want you to think just a minute. As some of us in this room, we all have a name. We've already come to that conclusion, right? When people hear your name, what do they identify you as? Do they identify you as a Christ follower? Do they identify you as someone that loves Jesus Christ? Do they identify you as someone that is seeking and striving to be more Christ-like? Guys, I wish I could answer that, because I know me, and there's times when I'm driving down the highway and I give a signal but not a turn signal. You follow me? I'm not exemplifying Christ. It doesn't matter what my name, because my actions are bad fruit at that time. But when people hear my name, I don't want them to recognize me as an executive director, as a pastor. For years, I was called Cody's dad. Those kids didn't even know my name. I'm honored by that. It's a blessing. I'm blessed to be Cody's dad. But at the end of the day, when people hear your name, do they identify you as a Christ follower? Names are important. Your name is important because it reflects who you are. Your actions reflect your identity and who and what you serve. Are you serving your name? Are you serving the one that knows your name? Think about that a minute. see, we all struggle with selfishness. We all struggle with wanting our way. We all struggle with our desires, our part of everything. But at the end of the day, do we serve the one who knows us by name? Listen to these words. Revelations chapter 20, verse 15, 11 through 15. This is the most important reason why your name is important this morning. And I saw a great white throne, and the one sitting on it. The earth and sky fled from his presence, but they found no place to hide. I saw the dead, both great and small, standing before God's throne. And the books were opened, including the book of life. And the dead were judged according to what they had done, as recorded in the books. And the sea gave up its dead, and the death and the grave gave up their dead. And all that were judged according to their deeds. Then death and the grave were thrown into the lake of fire. This lake of fire is the second death. Verse 15. And anyone whose name was not found recorded in the book of life was thrown into the lake of fire. Our name is important. God knows your name. God has called you by name. Maybe he's calling you by name this morning. And he wants to record your name, not your position, not the things you've done or the things you will do. He wants to record your name in the book of life. My prayer, what I'm looking the most forward to, is to be able to stand before my Father in heaven and hear these simple words. Well done, my good and faithful servant, Jeff. I can't wait to hear Jesus call me by name. Not because my name's important, because his name's important, but by calling me by name, it says that you are an heir to the kingdom of heaven. You are a child of the Most High God. But make no mistake, if your name's not in the book of life, he will look and say, "Depart from me, I never knew you." Doesn't mean he didn't know your name. It means he doesn't know who you are, because your fruit does not bear the likeness of Christ. Your name is important. Is your name written in the book of life? Do your actions reflect the identity of Jesus? My prayer is this, that today when you walk out of this building, and maybe that's going through your head, who am I? Who am I? By the time you lay down tonight, you will be able with confidence to say, I am a child of God. That's who you are. That's who God desires you to be. How do I know that? Because his word tells us that. Romans 10:13. Everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. Everyone who calls on the name of the Lord, that everyone, you can put your name in there. When Jeff called upon the name of the Lord, God saved me. When Bill called on the name of the Lord, God saved him. He wants your name in the book of life. What are you going to do with his name today? Because his name is all that matters. But your name is important because he knows your name. Father, I thank you for your word this morning. God, I thank you for the profoundness of a simple question our Savior asked the disciples. Who do people say that I am? Father, I know we can never be, never will be, even able to pick up the sandals of our Lord and Savior. But Lord, you know our name, and Lord, you desire for our name to be written in the book of life, to be part of your family. So Father, today I pray, Lord, as we reflect on who am I, God, that with a boldness and a confidence, we can say, I am a child of God. Lord, for the person in here this morning, Lord, that they're just confused. They're not sure. Ask that question, who am I? They don't know who they belong to. They don't even know where their name is written. Lord, I pray today is a day of clarity for them. God, as you are calling them through your Holy Spirit, Lord, I pray today that they will answer the call to you by name and come boldly before your throne. Lord, you tell us in your word, if we confess our sins, you are faithful and just to forgive us of all unrighteousness. Lord, you tell us in your word that if we confess Jesus as Lord and Savior, believe that he died on a cross, that he rose again, and that he's coming back, that we will be saved. God, it's my prayer that every one of us will bend on knee today and call you by name and tell you, thank you, Jesus, for saving us. Lord, I love our family here. And Lord, each name that is represented in here, each person that's represented by name, God, they are important. So, Father, I pray that you hold all of us accountable, Lord, to spur each other on towards love and good deeds. God, that we would be there to lift each other up, to motivate each other. Lord, to correct each other and discipline each other. But Lord, that we do it because we want to see good fruit. Lord, we want your harvest, your kingdom to grow. And Lord, I pray that you start with our family here in Dublin. Father, we love you. Lord, I thank you for saving me. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Maybe this morning you've got questions. Jimmy will be up here, myself, the lay pastors, elders will be around. Guys, don't leave here today without knowing that you know where you're going to spend eternity and without knowing that you know that your name is in the book of life. God bless y'all.
Wait.